Didn't quite get there. Hit the board straight to Pecora's stick. Now Pecora battling with Risley in the corner, and the rest going to blow that play dead.
One thing that the Mustangs are going to have to do to get on the board today is just simply fire some shots, because yesterday, despite winning 4-1, they had 13 shots the whole game. 13 shots, four of them went in. That's not going to happen today. They're going to need to create more opportunities. They also had 11 power play opportunities and only 13 shots, so that's just unacceptable.
And Saunders goes back into her own zone for the puck. She goes around her goal, and she tries to shoot it up, but a pigeon defenseman, Bannon, keeps it in. Bannon takes a quick shot on Campbell. Easy save for her. Nastasic passes it up to Ross, who loses the puck. Icing waved off as Saunders goes back for the puck. And she'll just tip it up the glass to Rolf. Saunders loses the puck. And now Cation has it. Cation battling with Balanchi in the corner. And Ross gets it to Saunders. Gosling now over to Rolf behind the Western goal. Rolf fanned on the pass attempt to Ross. And Kirby not able to take it away, and Ross will just flip it out and try and get it to Gosling, but glove down by Day, and that's going to be considered a hand pass, and we're going to get a whistle.
Yes, certainly a hand pass. You're only allowed to hand pass it to a teammate in your own defensive zone, since that one was in the neutral zone. The faceoff will take place just outside.
And Ricker comes away with it off the draw. She'll get across center ice and shoot it down for Danford. Not able to get to it due to Caitlin Gosling. And Krishandra Green now has it. And she passes it up to Stacy Scott, who gets her pocket picked by McClellan. Ricker, a nice move to get around Gosling there. Ricker has it in front of the net. Takes a weak shot that went off a stick up high and then gloved down by Gosling. Day has it over to Ricker. Ricker takes a shot and a glove save made by Kelly Campbell.
Yep, there's Kelly Campbell, as calm and ever in the net, scooping that one up with the glove. No rebound, nothing to worry about there. We just saw Caitlin Gosling out there for the Mustangs. She actually leads the entire, not only the OUA, but the entire CIS in points scored by a defenseman with 22.
Made by Kelly Campbell.
22 points in 21 games.
Day has it over to Ricker. Ricker takes a shot and a glove save made by Kelly Campbell.
Blues have it in their own zone.
Day has
tried to get it out, but it was Eli Zolino.
Ricker takes a shot.
Kept it in, tried to shoot it on net quick, but hit the skate of
Bohannon
and went out of play.
Ricker.
Yeah, we talk about how strong Kelly Campbell has been all year. In addition to leading the OUA in save percentage, she's tied for the OUA lead in wins with 15. So obviously wins are very important. Perhaps the most important goalie stat of all.
Togas passes it up to O'Hanlon, who passes it over to Weidenfelder. Gets bumped off the puck by Pecora. Oh, and a centering pass in front, nobody home. But a good shot by the defenseman, and a good glove save made by Kelly Campbell. Gosling passes it to Pecora. Pecora tried to pass it, gets pocket picked by Risley. And now Gosling has it behind her zone, loses it to Scheifele. Scheifele centers it in front. A couple of chances there for the Varsity Blues, but Kelly Campbell. Shot there by Loya, went just wide. Rosen taken down by Scheifele. I don't think we're going to get a call there, all clean. And Kidd comes away with the puck. Cross ice pass to Gosling. Tries to get it up to Nastasic or Galloway, but not able to do so. And here comes Loya and the Varsity Blues. Tries to pass and get a tip there by Kirby, but not able to get a stick on the puck. And Gosling has it behind her own goal. She'll try and flip it out, but kept in by Loya. Ooh, and a beautiful tip there. Out in front, but not able to get it in. That was great tip by Lela Chang Curry. Out, but kept in by Loya.
Yes, we talked about Kelly Campbell. Take a look at this save right in front. Oh, that's the one that she just made as she scooped it up. But earlier on, we saw Campbell make an outstanding save. I correct myself, not 15 wins to lead the OUA. She has 12 wins, tied with Brooke Sedell of Guelph.
And McClellan takes a shot that goes off Ricker's skate. Kept in by Janot. And Danford has it. Danford takes a shot on Campbell. Campbell playing really good here to start the game, with Varsity Blues just getting numerous chances. And Jessica Ross takes it into the territory. And she takes a shot that goes off McClellan's stick and into the netting and out of play.
We're going to take a look at the Female Athlete of the Week. It is Laura Daly from the women's basketball team. She had a triple-double and an 80-68 victory over Lakehead this past week, which is just outstanding. Congratulations to Laura Daly of the Western Mustangs women's basketball team.
Madison Turk took a shot on goal that went just wide. And she's able to keep the puck in there on an attempt to clear. Now Danford has it. Danford over to Day. Day breaking in. Day tripped up by Stacy Scott. And she's going to get a penalty here, I believe. Yes, it will be a trip.
Yeah, the Blues bench was applauding that one. I'm wondering if maybe there are a few other slashes and hacks that have gone uncalled, and finally one does. A trip, sorry. They were very happy about that one. We see the number one penalty kill, the Mustangs, 91%, but they take a lot of penalties. So get used to this.
Over to Loya. Clapham knocks down her man. O'Hanlon. And
I believe the faceoff is just going to come outside, a hand pass, or maybe just the Blues were the ones covering the puck, and so penalize them by bringing the faceoff outside. But 91.7% is the penalty killing for the Mustangs. Power play for the Blues is also very good, actually, at 17.3%, almost 20%, fourth in the OUA.
Clapham. Krishandra Green has it. Over to Saunders. Saunders will clear it. A minute 20 remaining here on the power play for the Varsity Blues. O'Hanlon has it for the Blues. She stops up behind her goal, and they're going to set up here. And she'll pass it up. And up to Ricker, and she comes into the Western zone. Ricker around the net, up to the top to Kirby. Back down low to Ricker, to the point. Kirby takes a shot, deflected by Scheifel in front, but just wide. McClellan down low to Scheifel. To Day. Day tried to center it for Ricker, but out of the reach of her stick and not able to connect. And now Galloway has it for the Mustangs. She'll play it back to Gosling. Gosling will shoot it all the way down the ice, 22 seconds remaining.
Yeah, very good penalty kill so far for the Mustangs. Let's hope they don't take 11 penalties. Oh, sorry, 6 they took yesterday, which is even still too many. They did kill off all 6 yesterday, but they got to stay out of the box.
And Mustangs penalty over. Back to 5-on-5 hockey as Pecora brings it across the blue line. Pecora tries to center for Scott. Just goes right in between her skates and not able to get a shot off. And here comes Weidenfelder. Passes it up to O'Hanlon. O'Hanlon gets a puck taken away by Gosling. Gosling up to Scott. Scott looked like may have gotten hooked there and taken down. And we're going to get a hook and call.
Yes, that's pretty obvious. Hook and call. We're going to look at the starting goaltender for Varsity Blues. It is Krista Funky, who has started 10 games this year and put up very, very impressive stats, almost similar to Kelly Campbell. 188 there, goals against average, 938 save percentage. You see, she has split time with the other goaltender who is not in tonight, Nicole Kesteris. And Campbell has played 17 games, a lot more than Funky, but Funky's stats, nonetheless, very, very impressive.
Puck just gets wedged up on the boards there, and the ref's just going to blow it dead.
Yes, so now we see the other side. We'll see the Mustangs power play, which has been, frankly, pretty horrendous this year at 12.7%. It's not been good at all year, and they need to work on that against a very good penalty kill for the Blues.
Gosling gets a good shot off, a good save made by Funky. And Danford will shoot the puck down the ice and clears it. Minute and a half remaining in the power play for the Mustangs. Cation tries to pass it to Gosling. And Danford, good defensive play, backhands it to Scheifele. Scheifele stops up. Works away in front of the net, takes a shot, and a save made. Rebound there for Danford, but not able to get a shot off. And it looks like we may have a delayed penalty here. And Western's gonna touch the puck. And not too sure what the penalty is here.
Yeah, we're gonna have a penalty.
Works away in front of the net.
It's gonna
be
another
shot,
hook.
A save made.
On the
rebound
Mustangs,
there.
Right about right there. As the hand goes up, yep, Sydney Kidd. Goes to the box. 2 minutes for the hook. Maybe a little soft, but you can't put your stick in there. That's the no zone. She interfered with the Blues player, Caitlin Bannon, who did very good on that penalty kill. She got a very good opportunity off, in addition to killing off a lot of time.
And now we have 4-on-4 play for the next 45 seconds, and Ricker loses her stick. And she's going to try and pin the puck against the boards, but Gosling able to get it away, and she goes and gets her stick. Yazzolino to Gosling, up to Krishandra Green. Green not able to keep hold of the puck. And now Loya has it for the Varsity Blues, and she'll dump it in. Varsity Blues going on a change here. And Yazzolino tips it in. Green loses the puck to Weinfelder. Weidenfelder. And now the Blues are on a power play for a minute as Stacy Scott comes out of the box. Sorry, the Varsity Blues player comes out of the box. O'Hanlon has it down low. She'll give it off to Fogas. Togas has it. Togas takes a shot from the side of the net and a routine save made by Kelly Campbell.
Yeah, so far early on in this one, not too many chances from either side, but it looks as though the Blues are controlling the majority of the play. They've had a couple good chances. Campbell's been there. She stood tall and not looked too panicked, but again, Mustangs are playing the majority of this first 12 minutes in their own zone.
Scheifele walks out in front, backhand shot, and gets a great rebound opportunity, but Kelly Campbell shut the door, and then play blown dead.
Yes, let's take a look at this great save. Scheifele sticks out the glove, unfortunately
front,
not able to catch it.
Shot and gets a
but that's just pure reflex, great save there from the netminder, Kelly Campbell.
Madison Turk has the puck. Kirby tries to center or put it out. That goes all the way to her goaltender, Funky. Here comes Bazic, takes a shot, went just wide. Risley not able to keep it in. Scheifele going back for it, being chased by Panahi. Scheifele up to Bazic. Bazic gets the puck back and gives it up to Madison Turk. Now Bazic with the puck once again, winds up, takes a shot, and a save made by Kelly Campbell. And with Day coming in, she's just going to hold on to that one.
Boy, Bazic has quite a shot, I must say. She had two shots on that last shift. And on net, well, easy save, but she certainly got some power in that one. She's got 10 goals on the year, so that's not surprising.
Damford loses the puck to Pecora. Cation over to Panahi, who gets it to Clapham. Clapham off the boards and into the Varsity Blue zone. Cation back to Pecora. Pecora tried to send it in, but it'll be Cation getting it into the zone, and gives it up to Scott. Scott with a quick shot and a good pad save made by Funky. Toga's cross-ice pass to Weidenfelder. Weidenfelder shot, blocker save made by Kelly Campbell. Bannon has it. Cross-ice pass. Toga's lets it go for O'Hanlon, but Terry Cation picks the puck up. O'Hanlon loses the puck. And now Togas has it. And shoots it right to Cassandra Green, who passes it up to Scott. Stacey Scott coming in, takes a shot just wide. Scott still with the puck, takes a shot, hoping to maybe get a deflection there. Now Green has it. Over to Gosling. Gosling. Bannon passes it to Mikawa. Taken away by Kidd. Kidd takes a shot that just misses wide. Scott battling in the corner, and the referee's going to blow the play dead.
Another reason why this matchup is so crucial, it's the second and final matchup between the two teams for this year, but if the playoffs were to start today, and they're not that far away, they would play each other, it'd be fourth versus fifth, and the last matchup between them was 3-2 earlier this year, 3-2 in overtime for the Varsity Blues, as we're going to get a penalty here.
And a big hit there by Risley. Not too sure who it was, but she's still down, and she looks hurt.
That was, frankly, looked like a bone-crushing hit.
Yeah, Western's going to go on the power play for that.
Unfortunately, from our angle, we can't tell who it is, who is down, as we're going to take some time, obviously take our time and see if she's okay. Attend to her as the trainer is out on the ice. It is right by the Varsity Blues bench, and there was no question about that one. It'll just be 2 for body checking. So the Mustangs will go back to the power play. A power play that needs help, undoubtedly, as it was Sydney Kidd, the defenseman for the Mustangs, who was just frankly taken out hard along the boards, and she is not even going to the bench, straight to the dressing room. And she'll be attended to. Probably just shaken up a bit. Hopefully nothing serious. As she appears to be stretching. Hasn't headed to the dressing room yet. She's off to the side by the track talking to the trainer. So she is a big part of this Mustangs defense.
Looks like it could be her shoulder as she's pointing to the trainer down low. That her shoulder is a little sore. Maybe that hit made a little sore, but Now Western on the power play, and right off the draw, Rolf gets a good chance there. Turk, cross-ice pass to Gosling. Down low to Panahi. And Panahi has it. Up top to the point to Gosling. Gosling to Rolf. Back to Panahi. To Rolf. To Gosling. Shot taken. Blocked by Makawa. And Turk down low to Rolf. Gosling to Turk, and a good slap shot. Great one-timer there, and Ross on the rebound. Another save made by Funky. Gosling to Rolf. Rolf to Panahi. Couple of chances there. Cassidy Gosling had a shot. And the Varsity Blues will ice it down the ice. Gosling tries to send it to Deller, but Loya will send it in, and O'Hanlon goes after it. 40 seconds remaining on the power play.
Three of them battling in the corner. You figure one of them would be able to fish out the puck by now. But a great play by the captain of the Blues to take some time off the clock, Kelly O'Hanlon. She is the captain
Makawa
of this squad.
And Turk down low to Rolf.
And a big part of the team.
Gosling.
Undoubtedly.
To Turk, and a good slap shot. Great one time. And Western has the puck as Cation battles in the back with Weidenfelder. And Scott comes up with it. A little bit of a two-on-one. Stacey Scott cross-ice pass. And a great save made by Funky off a shot by Cassidy Gosling. That almost made it 1-0 here. Saunders now has it behind the net. And Scott comes up to the point and gives it to Cation just out of her reach. And that's going to do it for the power play as Saunders goes back for it. And now Cation has it. Cross-ice pass to Saunders. Over to Deller. Deller gets it taken away. And Scott sends it down. And it's going to be iced, but Chandra Green pleading her case that she got a tip on it. It did look like it got tipped there at the blue line, though, whether it was by Makawa or Green.
Nonetheless, it'll come back, and the defensemen for the Mustangs were trying to change, and the ref said, you got to get back on the ice, and that's Saunders and Cation, so they're probably a little bit tired as well. I just want to add Kelly O'Hanlon, the captain of the Varsity Blues, not only the captain, leads the team in scoring with 24 points in 22 games.
Dankford, shot. Saunders blocks it. Now Krishandra Green has it. Up to Stacey Scott. And Scott will just get across center ice and shoot it down, but it seemed like it was an icing call. Not called, though. And Risley has it. Risley backhands it into the Western zone. Scheifele takes Green down. Galloway up to Ross. Ross to Galloway in her skates and couldn't get a shot off. Oh, has it to Risley. Scheifele will send it in and go after it, and she gets the puck back. Tries to center it out in front, but nobody home. And Gosling and Weidenfelder take a tumble there, and looks like Weidenfelder's going to get a penalty here as Campbell goes to the bench. And that's going to do it as they'll just ice the puck, and goaltender Funky comes out and touches it, and Weidenfelder goes to the box.
Yeah, this one is for the holding. It'll be a holding call. Thought it might have been a hook, but no. Cassidy Gosling was clearly taken out of the play on that one. And so, again, we'll see if this power play can get something going. Look for Caitlin Gosson there on the blue line, 51 for the Mustangs. She has a very good shot from the point. They got to try and set her up for a slapper or a one-timer.
Penny has it along the far boards. Over to Iazzolino down low. Rolf over to Ross, to Iazzolino. To Ross. Ross backhands it around the boards to Panahi. And Danford not able to keep the puck. And we're going to get a whistle here as that puck wasn't going anywhere.
One thing I'm really noticing the Varsity Blues are doing a lot is just keeping the puck and wasting time. And at some points, yes, it's a good thing to do if you're on the penalty kill side earlier in the offensive zone, just pinning it there. But they really like to waste time and just keep the puck on the boards.
Yeah, they do. Ooh, and a good shot off the draw by Saunders. Steered into the corner by Funky. Funky, another save. And Scott to Cation. Cross-ice pass to Gosling. Gosling, wrister. A good chance. And just as time expires, the puck ends up in the back of the net.
Yeah, that was a close one. That was actually a great shot from Cassidy Gosling. Right here on the right side, just a quick wrister going the other way, going for the top left corner. And it was a great blocker save from Krista Funky. And that almost time wound out, but they could have put one that way in on the rebound. And so after one, we are still tied at zeros. The Mustangs will start the second on a power play again, but for now, it is still 0-0 after one. We will be back with second period action, so please be sure to join us after one. The Mustangs 0, Varsity Blues 0.
New improved Powerade Ion 4 replenishes fuel and four of the minerals lost in sweat. Powerade Ion 4 hydrates better than water. Keep sweating. New improved Powerade Ion 4 replenishes fuel and 4 of the minerals lost in sweat. Powerade Ion 4 hydrates better than water. Keep sweating. New improved Powerade Ion 4 replenishes fuel and 4 of the minerals lost in sweat. Powerade Ion 4 hydrates better than water. Keep sweating. New improved Powerade Ion 4. New improved Powerade Ion 4 replenishes fuel and 4 of the minerals lost in sweat. Powerade Ion 4 hydrates better than water. Keep sweating. Improved Powerade Ion 4 replenishes fuel and 4 of the minerals lost in sweat. Powerade Ion 4 hydrates better than water. Keep sweating.
Here's your Domino's pizza.
Mechanic by day, soccer coach by night. I've been doing it for years now. It's fun. I use my Prius V to transport all of the equipment to our tournaments. Our last one was north of the city. I fed three kids, soccer balls, coolers, equipment, safety gear, pylons, and nets. I had no idea how much space was in that car. We played five games that day. Ended up third overall. Everyone was really happy. I didn't have to stop for gas on the way.